Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most kind. Connect to Allah because this line is never busy. Always answered, no hang up, no heartbreak. But how we connect to Allah? Allah took responsibility for who reads the Quran and acts on what is in it. He won't go astray in this life, nor despair in hereafter. Today we will discuss clinical presentation, gross morphology, microscopic features of complete and partial mole. Mole is molar pregnancy is also called hydatidy form mole. A hydatidy form mole represents a non-invasive abnormal placenta, characterized by grossly evident hydropic swelling of chorionic villi, accompanied by trophoblastic proliferation. How this pregnancy occurs? There are two types, partial mole or complete mole. In partial mole, the ovum is fertilized by two sperms, so there is maternal tissue as well. But in complete mole, blighted or empty ovum is fertilized by a single sperm, which then duplicate, or there are two sperms fertilizing empty ovum. There is a clinical presentation. There is hyperemesis because there is excessive amounts of HCG. So patient may present with large for dates, that the actual time duration for pregnancy is large for dates, size of the uterus is larger than dates, and there is common presentation is passage of grape-like structures per vaginum. Now the scenario is 18 years old primary gravida presented in ER with complain of amenorrhea for 3 months, followed by pervaginum bleeding for 2 days with passage of grape-like vesicles. So this is the commonest clinical presentation. Grossly placenta, these are grape-like structures, and there is no fetal part along with placental tissue. Now if we examine the placenta under microscope, there are distended chorionic villi with no blood vessel, avascular core, and there is peripheral trophoblastic proliferation. As you can appreciate, yellowish outline show there is proliferation of trophoblastic tissue. So we can summarize avascular distended villi, and there is trophoblastic proliferation. In case of partial mole, there is malformed fetus and occasional grape-like structures in placenta. Now you can appreciate the glistening distended chorionic villi, which are highlighted in this picture. So there is malformed fetus and distended occasional grape-like structure or chorionic villi. If you see the in under microscope, there are two population of villi: dilated avascular distended villi and small fibrotic villi. So they are in the dilated villus is in the lower part, and the bluish lines are arrowing towards fibrotic villi. If you see the normal placental tissue for comparison, normal chorionic villi, they have fetal blood vessels. So these are fetal blood vessel inside the villi, and there is no hydropic change, there is no swelling, and you can appreciate there is single layer of trophoblastic tissue, cytotrophoblast. There is no trophoblastic proliferation in normal placental tissue. So, in partial mole, microscopically, there are two populations of chorionic villi, avascular and fibrotic. So, if we compare the features of partial and complete mole, karyotype complete mole is diploid and partial mole is triploid. Embryonic tissue absent in complete mole, present in partial mole. Hydrophic swelling diffuse in complete and partial in partial mole. So we can summarize: amenorrhea followed by passage of grape-like structures per vaginum. Grossly, there is diffuse grape-like appearance of placenta and avascular villi with trophoblastic proliferation. So diagnosis of name of the lesion is hydatidiform mole. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe the channel, like and share this video.